requires a massive welcome. On safari, from Aaron and myself, both Gunwerks and Johnny Safaris. Thanks for coming a million miles across the ocean in 3 days worth of traveling. I'm sure it's going to be worth it. When you wake up here tomorrow morning, it's going to be magnificent. When you see all the animals, you can see the terrain, the countryside, and all the opportunities it does allow for the long-range shooting. I'm sure you guys tomorrow night will just be absolutely amazed what you saw, what you experienced, and what will hit this off tomorrow. We know the guns, we know the terrain, and I know the team I've got, so you guys will be into it thick tomorrow.
Do now, you're going to shoot the 100 yards right over here, this first one, and all you're going to be doing, I'm going to put it on.
Yes, I'm ready.
I'm going to put it on that there. That's at 100 now.
Betting down.
Okay.
That's great. We'll just hang 10 years.
Right, guys, this is the end result of a hardybee stalk that we had. We snuck up over the ridge behind us, and the bull for a moment looked like he was bedded down, but actually he was just in a little wash, standing with all the cows, and we got him at, ranged him at 664 yards, and Paul put in a good shot, and yeah, he went on a little bit, and he just walked up, and we just had to do one more shot to finish him off, but it was good shooting there. Paul, congratulations on your first African animal. It's a beautiful hartebeest, this.
Thank you.
It's a real nice trophy.
It's beautiful.
Reload. You hit him, reload. Reload.
Well done, Paul. You got a nice blissback ram, yeah?
Beautiful.
Just 20 minutes earlier, we were loading a hartebeest bull, and we took a drive down this canyon down below us, and we spotted a bachelor group of 6 rams, and this was the oldest ram amongst them, and he did a great shot at 452 yards, I think it was, eh?
Yes.
Prone shot, and the blissback ran maybe 60 yards and piled up. What do you say, Paul?
Beautiful animal, thank you so much again.
Well done, man, good shooting.
Carries his mass all the way up the top. We saw him a couple different times. We were able to get into a little draw, work our way up. Kind of came up over the top of the draw there about 60 yards away. They moved off a little bit. and the Impala Ram stopped, and as you can see the end result, he is sitting here now. Beautiful animal, and I couldn't be happier. Facing to the right.
All by himself.
Yep. Okay. 337.
That was the last reading, yeah. This is 337 and whatever it was, he's down.
He's down?
Yep.
Okay. Well, Greg and Jose, we took a little walk today. Walked up to this rim rock, looked over the other side, and we saw a bunch of springbuck. And found a real nice male right here. Ranged at 380 yards and took one shot and knocked it down, landed where it was standing. Pretty awesome animal, amazing cape, and beautiful. Came in with a rain and had a rainbow right before we were able to take some pictures. So all in all, absolutely perfect day.
She's way bigger than I expected. My boy Russ put us on this beautiful animal at about 475 yards and the gun did the rest and they helped us pull her down. But she's a big old beast.
Gabe made a brilliant shot. We got up to this Impala. I mean, it was last light, last minute, and he just stepped out, gave us a perfect shot, and he made a beautiful shot. Well done, eh? Awesome day. Two beautiful trophies in the salt.
picture.
Well, Greg, thanks again for helping me get this. We saw it as we were driving up, snuck up behind a dam, looked over, and it was, what, about 800 yards away?
Yep.
We didn't even have to range it.
Not this time.
And got one nice shot, landed where it stood, and the rest is in front of us. An absolutely beautiful white cape, nice heavy bases, very nice old mature ram. Thank you very much.
No, it's a pleasure. No, he's a... This ram is actually past being mature, you could say. He's you can see how he's worn his tips off a bit, but he's still got that little bit of a shape to him, and very, very nice old ram to shoot. He was the oldest ram in the bachelor group there.
He's absolutely
and
gorgeous.
Actually one of the cleanest ones, if you could call it that, with as far as the whiteness goes. But well done. Let's go see if we can get a black wildebeest. That's what we're going to try next.
Excellent. Thank you.
Thank you. Hey guys, here's Paul's black wildebeest that he got. As you saw on the video there, he did a good shot. And how far is that, Paul? 212?
212 yards.
Yeah, this is the bull that we were stalking that we had seen from way back over there. I think it was almost a mile, you could say, that we did the stalk, and we came out through the acacia into a dry dam. And Paul was able to sneak up over the wall and get a good rest there. And he did a great shot on this nice pull.
Thank you.
Well done.
Appreciate it.
Thank you, bless.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Thanks, my man. Bedingos.
Kosamulela.
Thank you.
Tangi.
Right, folks, we're coming to the end of our third day of Paul's safari with John X. We've been looking for kudu this afternoon. We saw a great big old Cape buffalo that we spent about 15 minutes with just checking him out. And we came up onto the hill and we're going to do some more glassing for kudu. And Paul and I discussed maybe the possibilities of shooting a lecher if we saw a nice old bull. And this bull came out and presented itself with a younger bull. And Paul did a great shot. What distance was that again, Paul?
299.
299 yards and...
at about a 20 degree angle, yeah. Downhill.
So he made sure of his shot. It was getting a bit late, but he did a perfect shot on this great old bull. And he's going to make a beautiful shoulder mount. Congratulations. I think it is a wise choice to hunt one of these.
All right. Well, thank you so much.
Pleasure, man.
There we go!
Finally, hey? Good job,
Good job!
Well done, my man.
Good job.
Is that close enough for you, Alex?
Let's get this over with.
Well, it's been a long morning, and he was running all over the field and no wind, so he didn't smell us, came down the fence and offered me a shot at about 62 yards, and I got lucky and put him down.
Good shooting, man. Well done, eh?
Well done, my man. What a shot. What a shot.
Well, we saw this white spring buck at about 1,000 yards. We stalked up to about 750 yards. I took a shot and I missed. We creeped up to about 450 and I dropped him on the spot. Thanks to Rusty.
Awesome. Well done, my man.
Thank you. We're still after kudu today, and as you can see, rather overcast, quite cold there, Paul.
In shorts?
Yeah, well, you know, can't get long pants in this part of the world, so hopefully we can find a decent kudu bull, and I'm sure Paul will make a great shot. Take it. On the front shoulder.
Over.
Over. No, no. He's yes. Dead. Well done.
He's dead. It wasn't over, it was through.
Straight through it.
Okay.
That was just a joke. We knew you hit it.
Oh, did you?
Yeah.
Well, thanks again, Greg, for bringing me up this beautiful impala. Well, we were about 425 yards when we first saw him.
That's right.
Kind of ran a little ways, settled back down, got on him. I think we shot first time at 400, a little
correct,
over 400.
Yes.
Wind's a little bit stronger than we anticipated. Ended up hitting him. He was stood there for a little bit. Took a second shot right at, what, 385?
385,
and he went
yeah.
Right down. So,
a great shot in this wind and conditions. Nice impala.
Thanks again. Beautiful animal.
Yeah, we're still trying to find the elusive kudu, but I'm sure we'll get there.
We got five more days.
We've got 5 more days, and that's a wonderful trophy. Well done there.
Thank you, sir.
Ricky, reload. He's going up the other side.
Got him.
Hit him again.
Get him?
Yep. Beautiful bull. Good shooting, man.
Thank you, sir.
All right. Guys, yeah. The late on day 5, we managed to get this great kudu bull that Paul spotted himself. Did a great shot, 350 yards. Well done, Paul.
Thank you, sir.
It's been 5 days looking for a great kudu, and what a great trophy.
He is awesome.
What a shot, my man.
What a shot.
Thank you.
Right, guys, we've been running after kudu for 2 days. Got up to a kudu this morning and walked into the brush. But we decided to come for impala. We saw these nice, it was a bachelor herd of a couple of rams. Saw this nice ram standing broadside, and we just snuck through this brush. And Alex, you made a beautiful shot. Well done, my man.
Thank you.
Right, morning, guys. This is our second last day of our safari with Paul. We've encountered bad weather for the last 2 days, and today's not much better. But anyway, we're trying to complete his slam or spiral horns, and we just need the bushbuck now. We got a wonderful Nyala bull the other day, so sitting up here, I know of an old ram that lives down across the river below us. So hopefully we see it, and next time you see us, maybe we'll be sitting with a great old bushbuck.
There is it. Okay, guys, well done, Paul.
Thank
completion
you.
Of your spiral on animals. It's not often you can achieve that in one safari and collect another, what is it, if you take the four away, another 12 great trophies, all good old animals. We spotted this bushbuck from the hill about, you could round it off at 500 yards, actual shot 497, and gusting wind. To give you guys an idea of where Paul had to aim, for more layman terms, so it would be like the crosshairs would have been over here on the animal, and that's how the bullet drifted in, and he gave it a great shot. And I'm very proud of that, Paul, and I'm proud of you for doing that shot. It's a wonderful way to finish off your spiral horns. Well done, man.
Well, thank you, sir. I appreciate
Thanks.
It.
Okay, well, the rain finally stopped and there were bushbuck all over the place, and we picked out this big old guy. Down in condition, we got to about 280 odd yards. Made a hell of a shot there, it's right through the engine room here. He didn't go anywhere but kicked around a bit, and that's a wonderful trophy. It's the prize of the Eastern Cape, the bushbuck. We're all very fond of hunting them, and you can see our passion rubs off onto our hunters, and they also quickly become excited with hunting the bushbuck. So well done, that's a hell of a trophy. You made a good shot, man.
Thank you.
Good start to the morning.
Okay, this is number two for the day. She's doing very well here in the pouring rain. This pig disappeared at first, but then it came back out and a lot closer than we had bargained on, and we had to shoot downhill sharp, and Alexander made a wonderful shot again, took off running, and came and fell over here in the river here where the dog found it, so we were quite lucky. But a hell of a nice pig in trying conditions, and they make a great skull mount. I'm sure you'll look at this with fond memories for the rest of your life.
Definitely.
Well done, man. Congratulations.